And there was another topic, if we could move on to that. We would like to discuss a bit with you about coral food and coral nutrition. And about these products we have been using. I mean, Coral Sprint, Mines, we have also been using Coral Balance, that we have come to a perception, not really food, but a cleaning station, a cleaning purpose.
It's a little bit everything of all.
Coral Vitality, and some not really food, but trace nutrition organic.
Exactly.
So, in terms of coral food, we have been noticing some of these products are, I mean, pretty clean or even clean the aquarium better. Some do have nutrients, like for example, maybe Mines
and Coral Sprint, right?
Yeah.
So, tell us a bit about this product. How do you believe you should manage that?
Everybody's asking about the food. And I see you buy everything. So first of all, this is the right way. Now we talk about the food, how to use it. So if you buy it, it's okay. Now we talk about to use it. Okay, the foods are, I create food for different purposes at the end. So some is using together. The amine and the organic is a system where I call the Bali reef, where you said, okay, you have the baleen light, you take amino acids and trace elements and give the fish food and then ready. That's it. That's for all the normal things. Let me say red montiporas, green slimers, Amilca coral, these things. You can run with it and it's no issue. The mean S is, the one is the protein section, it's the sprint. The mean S is the fat, protein, and fatty acid. And the amine is amino acid and vitamins. So at the end, all different foods containing that, but in different amounts. If you have now, if you go a tank in direction US style, you need a little bit more and other kind of proteins together with saturated, unsaturated fatty acids to creating the fluorescent and to creating that type of coral. So that's why these people using more, let me say, Mines with Sprint together. If you have a soft tank, let me say a lot of Ophelia, Zoanthus like that, you use the coral dust. And maybe if you try to want to keep, you can give a little bit more proteins to get a more clean coloration, then you use a little bit of Sprint. But it's completely different amount where you have to use then, depending on the amount of the weight of the cores which is in. If you have a US style tank with small frags, you have only, let me say, 20 grams of a living material. When I see the tank with the Ophelias in the background, we're talking about hundreds of gram, of course. So that's why it's so different to see how much I feed. That's why I said starting is very, very, very low. It means one drop of Mines in 200 liters is for many tanks enough. If the tank is full of Ophelias and full of clams and stuff, it's not enough. So you need a little bit more, but you can start and then you can see, oh, okay, maybe I give a little bit more. As long as your glass becoming not green and white, usually you are quite okay. If you see it's growing a little bit more in glass, other things you are too much, you go on the half and restart again. That's the point. How we creating the food. As long as a powder food, it's more for the beginners. And let me say, if you have corals, we can catch. The acroporas, we feed the amino acids a little bit and the Mines by drops. And when I be ready, like I say, now it's okay, it's running, then I add the core vitality. So this is always on top for playing around. This makes no sense to you. That kind of products as soon as the base is not stable. And that's also what we try really, really to explain. The best thing to get colors in covers, colors on covers or healthy covers, has nothing to do with the amount of food. It has nothing to do with the light or the skimmers. It has definitely to do how stable you can drive the conditions in your reef tank, starting from the temperature, ending on the carbonite hardness, and all between must be as stable as possible. If you feed low, they need a little bit longer to grow, but can create better colorations. If you feed along, you can let them grow stronger. But if you change all the time, it's difficult. And these reef tanks who are so amazing over years, like you see sometimes in our group, they keep it stable as possible with very low amount of food, but with very regular dosing so that they have a long way. And all the corals which get too much food at the beginning, getting brown, then they're starting to grow, then they use it, and then they create the colorations, amazing strong, but over the time. And not that I give now 100 milliliters of Minesse inside and wonder why the color's not coming. And when I don't check the calcium and the carbonate or the fluorescents like bromine, fluorine, and the things are missing, then the corals cannot use the food. So I say always, low food giving, and step by step the tank's growing, raising up, but keep it stable.
So this... if I understood well, you meant the vitality as a, let's say, end of the line, corals are already great, and this two colors.
Yeah, this is kind of
the same idea of vitality. Let's say corals are great, I just want that extra polishing.
I will show you. You can find it also on the website under the section biotopes. There I make recipes. What is the sense behind? The sense behind this is always a little bit when I have three different groups of people. So we have the beginner, we have the normal users, the medium, and we have the profs. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All the three. Now I have the Balling Light. The Balling Light, you can create, let me say, 75% of that what you need, and the stability you create with the primary care. That's it. Mm-hmm. So also one advantage is why I do it on that way, because I don't want that the base is changing. Mm-hmm. So I say to 75-80%. Keep it stable and let it run. You will have a nice reef tank. Not amazing, but a nice one.
Mm-hmm.
Now, let me say you have the usual users and say, I have 5 bottles, 10 bottles, I don't want. So I said, take the amine, take the organic, and you're done. The professional wants to play a bit more as a coloration. I say, don't use the all-in-one. Use the color elements where you can play a little better. But you play always on the 80%, yeah? That means this is Balling Light and then coming, and then you add on top the color element. So the difference is that the trace elements and the macro elements, which are on Balling Light, are also macro, means strontium and this type, and potassium in a total different way. The trace elements on top, there I need a little bit more iodine, add a little bit more heavy metals. I see how is the coloration, but I never change the base. So my playing ground is 20%.
Mm-hmm.
If you have an all-in-one system, which let me say all other brands do at the end, you change always the whole system. So if you want more iodine, you have to dose more of this one, but then you dose all the other ways also. And never in a relation. So, and I want only play on the top.
Mm-hmm.
And the completely crazy guys, which like to have a different color on a polyp. Yeah. So I don't know why people do that, but sometimes they will have fun. They play then here on top. they play around with a little bit more protein. They play around with core vitality. This is for the this is for the crazy guys at the end. So to playing around.
And we know some crazy guys like that here with some